एनी टाइप ऑफ गियर, तो बीम स्ट्रेंथ। ओके, सो आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर दी नेक्स्ट लेक्चर रिलेटेड टू मशीन डिजाइन सेकंड, एंड नाउ वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द बीम स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ स्क्वायर गियर। सो द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ बीम स्ट्रेंथ, इट इज ऑल्सो दिस इक्वेशन इज ऑल्सो नोन एज लेविस इक्वेशन। सो द एनालिसिस ऑफ बेंडिंग स्ट्रेस इन द गियर टूथ वॉज डन बाय विल्फ्रेड लेविस इन हिज पेपर द इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ गियर टूथ सबमिटेड एट द इंजीनियर्स क्लब इन 1892। सो इवन टूडे फ्रॉम 1892 टू टूडे टिल द लेविस इक्वेशन इज कंसिडर्ड एज वन ऑफ द बेसिक इक्वेशन इन द डिजाइन ऑफ गियर। इन लेविस एनालिसिस द टूथ इज ट्रीटेड एज अ कैंटिलीवर बीम एंड द टेंजेंशियल कॉम्पोनेंट पीटी कॉजेज द बेंडिंग मोमेंट अबाउट द टूथ। सो सी हियर द डायग्राम क्लियरली इंडिकेट दैट इट इज कंसिडर्ड एज द कैंटिलीवर। कैंटिलीवर वन एंड इज फिक्स्ड, वी हैव डिस्कस इन आवर स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल ऑल्सो। सो वन एंड इज फिक्स्ड एंड अदर एंड इज फ्री। सो द गियर टूथ इज कंसिडर्ड एज हियर कैंटिलीवर, कैंटिलीवर बीम as shown in the figure. This equation is very basic equation which is called as the Lewis equation. So if you refer to the diagram, okay, so beam strength equation. So if you see here this figure, so it is considered as the cantilever. So cantilever, so if you see any of the cantilever, if you see, then this is one of the beam and it is thin. Now, and if load is applied at the end, we will be considering this as the cantilever beam. One end is fixed, other end is free. So now if you see the gear also, then this gear at one side, see here, I am highlighting in the figure. So here, whatever it is shown dotted at this particular end, it is fixed. It is assumed to be fixed by Lewis, and the other side is assumed to be free. And again, the PT, it is assumed that uniformly distributed. So see here the tangential component, PT. We have seen the two components, PT and PR. So PT, tangential load applied. So see here, it is shown that the PT causes the bending moment. So this is the very basic structure and diagram. So while taking the notes, beam strength of gears, this diagram is very important. So I will give you here 5 minutes for drawing the diagram for this derivation. So here in this particular case, B is assumed as the face width. We have discussed this B generally taken as 10 times of module. Then T is the thickness and H is the height. H is the height of the tooth, T is the thickness of the tooth, B is the face width, and PT is the tangential load acting on it. And it is considered as the cantilever. So I request you to just for draw the diagram, take 2-3 minutes and complete the diagram. Beam strength give heading as Lewis equation also for spur gears, and this is very first diagram. Lewis has considered the tooth as a cantilever beam, and the P is assumed to be uniformly distributed over the beam as a cantilever. Put in the chat box over if your diagram is over. so that I will proceed for further point. Or please reply. Okay, let us go to next point. So after considering this as a cantilever beam, so now what is next step done by Lewis? So Lewis equation is based on some of the assumptions. So the assumptions we can say very first assumption is the effect of radial load is totally neglected. It is compressive stresses generating. So in this equation, the effect of radial load, it is completely neglected. See, the effect of radial load neglected, not considered. Due to radial load, whatever compression stresses are there, it will also be not considered. So this effect of radial load not considered. This is first assumption by Lewis. Then PT is uniformly distributed, stress concentration neglected, and only one pair at a time. So PT, if you refer the diagram, what is shown here in this. So if you see here what is shown, so you can see here completely whatever it is shown. So it is showing that it is uniformly distributed. This is symbol of uniform distribution of load. But in actual practice, it may not be the case. So second assumption is mentioned that PT is uniformly distributed. This is second assumption made by Lewis. Then third assumption, the effect of stress concentration. So stress concentration, you might have heard where there are sharp corners, assuming this, that here, see here. Whatever the pointers are here, so here some at this particular junction, at this particular junction, at this side also, bottom side. So wherever there are corners, direct change in shape, etc. At such pointers, it may be subject to stress concentration. But the effect of this stress concentration is also neglected. At this point, if you refer, definitely there will be stress concentration. So the effect is neglected in the analysis. And last is, this we have discussed, at any one point, we have discussed that there are at least two pairs in contact, at least two pairs taking the load simultaneously. But this is not considered. It is considered that only one pair is in contact and taking the complete load. So these are the assumptions made by Lewis in the beam strength. The first assumption, once again, I will repeat, the effect of radial component PR is neglected, which induces the compressive stresses. It is not considered at all. Then it is assumed that the tangential component PT, I have shown you, it is uniformly distributed over the face width. The gear should be rigid, and very high accuracy in machining is required for uniformly distribution of the load. Then the effect of stress concentration is neglected, and it is assumed that at a time only one pair of teeth in contact and take the load, but at a time there are two pairs which are simultaneously in contact and taking the load. So this effect is neglected. So these are the some pointers. Let us move further. So before moving further, so next, go to next point, beam strength. So now, if you consider the cross section of a gear teeth, if you consider the cross section of a gear teeth, then at any point, it is not constant. It is varying cross section. For example, you take any assumption that if you take the cross section like this, a straight portion you assume, uniform cross section. But for our case, if you take the cross section of a gear, the cross section is like this, again somewhat constant, and again like this. So this is the cross section of a gear. So it is observed that the cross section of tooth varies from free end to fixed end. So I will assume this point as free end. I will assume this point as fixed end. So there is a continuous variation in the profile from free end to fixed end. Therefore, a parabola is constructed. What is mentioned? A parabola is constructed within the profile shown by a dotted line. So this, as it is not having a fixed cross section, purposefully, intentionally, if you refer here, you can observe here like this. What is shown is like this: a parabola is constructed in the profile, as shown in the figure. They are why parabola? The parabolic outline, it is assumed as the uniform strain. So Lewis assumed that whatever the our gear tooth profile is there, like this, then again like this, and like this. So it is having somewhat variation. So if I construct a parabola inside this, like this, then it is assumed to be as a parabola with having uniform strength. So therefore, for this point only, parabola is constructed. Then, for the beam at any cross section is uniform. For this beam, the stress at any cross section. Why parabola? This parabolic line will give stress at any cross section is uniform or same. Same stress will be there. Now you see the weakest section of the gear tooth. So if you take a cantilever, any cantilever like this, it is acting. What is the weakest section? The weakest section is this point. It is, there are chances that it will fail through this point. So if I will take a gear, definitely you assume any of this, like this gear will be there. And if I will apply a load like this with intensity, definitely, what is the point? If I will extend the load, enlarge, 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 I am applying the load like a cantilever only. The weakest section will be this section XX, so bottom side. There are chances that it will fail at this particular section, weakest section, because cantilever, it is failing at this particular junction. So this is the weakest section for the cantilever. Okay, so this is about this particular diagram. Then before going for this calculation, and again here in this particular case, the diagram is again, you can observe here, if you observe the pointers, here if you observe, then you can easily come to know that this is component, radial component. This is the tangential component, PT. So what is this? This will be the PN. PN is not considered here, so PT. And we have, that author has considered here a point. This is the parabola of uniform straight at the apex of whatever height point of maximum point of parabola. The load PT is acting, the load PR is acting at point O. This is the height H. This is the height H from the section XX or bottom. Then T is the thickness. It is mentioned T is the thickness and B is the face width. We have already discussed what is face width. So B is the face width, that particular section XX. These are the details. And once again, I will repeat for you that the cross section of the tooth varies from C like this. See the pointers. And again, like this. So it is not uniform from free end. This is the free end and this is the fixed end. So a parabola is constructed. The parabola is assumed to be uniform strength, and therefore the stress value at any of the point it will be constant or same. Therefore, parabola is constructed. Now this is the thickness t, this is the height h, and xx is the weakest section or weaker section where there are chances that it will fail. The parabola is tangent to tooth profile. Why this is weakest? That I have given you idea. This is weaker due to cantilever is assumed. So I request you, I give you now a time of 3 to 4 minutes to complete this diagram. Then we will move further for writing next derivation part. You can complete this diagram also. Over. So this is about the beam strength. So once again, okay, so we have discussed about these points, the beam strength, and what is parabola, how this parabola is particularly constructed. And now let us discuss one by one about these different points. So I will be writing, and you will be also complete write, complete the write up. Okay, so we have discussed that section XX is the weakest, or we can say the weaker section. Section XX is the weaker section. So I will write here, we will start at section XX. I have already told you section XX is the weaker section. This is C here. Here is the section XX shown. So at this particular section, if I want to write, then how I can write MB? So if I say here, MB is equal to MB, I am taking the moment. If I want to take the moment is given by here, bending moment MB. It is nothing but force into perpendicular distance. Here I can say the force as this. Here I can say the force as this particular PT. So PT is the force and perpendicular distance is H. So I can write here MB is equal to very first PT into H. MB is equal to PT into H. Then second part, I want to take the moment of inertia, I for this case. So we are having moment of inertia for a rectangular section is given by 1 by 12 BD cube, 1 by 12 BD cube. So here I will write down 1 by 12 into B into T cube. Here D is nothing but T. Here in this case, D is nothing but T. So this is your I, moment of inertia for this particular section. If it is not understanding, if you explain, extend the teeth like this. So this part, if you take, then this is nothing but your B part. This is nothing but your B part, and this is nothing but your T part. So if you consider the rectangle, this is for your understanding, and whatever this is shown, it is nothing but the section XX. So if I want to highlight, I can highlight in this way, in this particular section, if I want to highlight whatever this part is shown, this is nothing but your section XX. Okay, so here I can say 1/2 into BD cube, so B into T cube. So I will take as 1/2 into BT cube. So this is for your understanding purpose, how this figure is there. Then next I will go for Y. So we have studied in the subject Y. Y is the distance of the extreme fiber from the NA, neutral axis. So if I assume that this is the neutral axis, so the distance I want, distance of the extreme fiber, this is the neutral axis and this distance. So what is this distance? Distance of this highest point from the neutral axis. This the Y distance we have already studied in this particularly basic. If you go in the strength of material or analysis of mechanical element subject, in this we have discussed this Y as for I section, for different section, for rectangular section. So for rectangular section, it is nothing but D by 2. So here it is not D by 2. So I will take here it is D is nothing but you can take this as T by 2. So this is your Y. Now we are having the formula for bending stresses. We are having the here in this case, I will write formula for bending stresses. So I will use more space. The bending stresses are given by. So here. Bending stresses are given by. We are having the formula. This formula also you might have studied, M by I is equal to sigma by Y. M by I is equal to sigma by Y. Here we are considering bending and bending stresses. Therefore, I will attach the suffix as sigma B. So MB by I is equal to sigma B by Y. Therefore, sigma B is given by सिग्मा बी इज गिवन बाय एम बी इनटू वाई डिवाइडेड बाय आई, वेयर आई स्टैंड फॉर द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया. नाउ इफ यू रेफर, वी आर हैविंग द वैल्यू ऑफ एम बी, वी आर हैविंग द वैल्यू ऑफ वाई एंड वी आर हैविंग द वैल्यू ऑफ आई. सो सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज, सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज. आई कैन से हियर Substitute the values. I can say here sigma b is equal to, I will take on this side, sigma b is equal to mb pt into h. This is the value of mb into y. Y value is nothing but t divided by 2. And now here divided by I value is nothing but 1 by 12 bt cube. This bracket complete, this bracket complete. So this is the sigma b. Sigma b is equal to m by y into I. I am having the mb value as pt into h. Here only we have written the value. Then y value as t by 2 we have written, and I value as 1 by 12 into bt cube, that also we have written. So sigma b is equal to pt into h into t by 2 divided by 1 by 12 bt cube. So I will rearrange the term. I will rearrange the term. So I can write directly after rearranging some modification. So these two will be there. Here it will become 6. If I want to write, I will directly go for writing for PT. I will write for PT. So PT, you can write B into sigma b, just rearranging the terms, nothing special. B into sigma b into this t will, one t will get cancelled. Here it will become t square. So t into sigma b into, in bracket I will write here purposefully, t square divided by, t square divided by 6h. Like this I can modify. I have converted the complete equation into, in terms of PT, just a simple rearranging, nothing special, nothing any separate arrangement is made. So I will take the next step. So we will take at next slide the next step. So I will take the next step as, here you write down multiplying the numerator and denominator of right hand side by module. Multiply the numerator and denominator of right hand side by module. So what it will become? So I will write down here PT is equal to MB MB sigma B into bracket T square divided by 6HM. What I have done in this case? So I have just simplified, just I have gone for this m and this m, multiplying the numerator and denominator by m. So now here this is the time to define a factor y. So defining a factor capital Y. So capital Y is nothing but, in bracket you write down, it is nothing but Lewis. It is nothing but Lewis form factor. It is nothing but Lewis form factor. So what is this Lewis form factor defined by Lewis? So now if you see, it is nothing but this. I will write down defining a factor Y here. So y is nothing but into bracket t square divided by 6 hm. So whatever term in the bracket, Lewis has defined the term as Lewis form factor y. So the equation will become, now if I will substitute in the equation, if I will substitute this value of y in the above equation, it will become Pt is equal to m b sigma b and y. Pt is equal to m b sigma b and y into y, equation number one. Equation number one. So in this equation, the term y is Lewis form factor. I will give you time 1 to 2 minutes. In this equation, it is expected that you are with me and writing simultaneously. So this form factor y is Lewis form factor. Lewis form factor. So this, what is this equation A? So equation one or equation A, it is give relationship between tangential force. It is giving relationship between tangential force PT and the very important word, tangential force PT and the corresponding stress sigma b. So this is the equation which gives the tangential force PT and corresponding stress sigma b. This is giving the equation between these two parts. So this is okay. Now let us proceed further. Again, the main derivation part is up to this only. Then if I will proceed further, then the tangential force is increased, the stress also increases. When this particular tangential force increases, the stress also increases. When the stress reaches to permissible magnitude of the bending stress, the corresponding PT is called as the beam strength. Beam strength. Once again, I will repeat with the help of this particular equation. So you refer in this equation. So you see, if this is the PT, if PT increases, sigma B increases. Again, increasing in PT, sigma B increase. Again, increase in PT, sigma B increase. So the sigma B will reach up to the maximum permissible value. It is the bending stress. So maximum bending permissible stress. And when the sigma B will reach to maximum permissible value, the corresponding value of PT for which it has reached to this value, this PT value is called as the beam strength of the particular gear. This value is called as the beam strength of the particular gear. So the beam strength can be defined as, it is the maximum value of tangential force that the tooth can transmit without a bending failure. See here, PT. So M is the module, B is the face width, Y is the Lewis form factor. So PT, there is a relation between sigma B only. So the beam strength, that PT is replaced by SB now, beam strength. And the beam strength is defined as the maximum value of the tangential force that the tooth can transmit without bending failure. So replacing the PT by SB and making it to the final form. So you can see here in the next slide also it is written. So PT, if I will replace it by SB, SB is the beam strength. I can write as m b sigma b into y, where m stands for the module, b stands for the face width, the sigma is the permissible bending stresses, and y is the Lewis form factor. So replacing PT by SB, the equation becomes SB is equal to m b sigma b y, and this is the, we can say this as the final equation. I will call it as the Lewis equation for beam strain of spur gear. It is the Lewis equation for beam strength of spur gear. And here you can see SB, it is the beam strength is Newton. SB is not a stress, it is the force. So for SB is in Newton. Sigma B, the permissible bending stress in Newton per mm square. And this equation is called as the Lewis equation. So friends, this is the derivation of a Lewis equation. SB is equal to MB sigma B Y. The derivation part is over here, but there are some points which we have to discuss for which are required for solving a problem or designing whether the pinion is weaker or gear is weaker and how to proceed for the design for any of the parts. So Lewis form factor we have discussed now. Lewis form. So what is this Lewis form factor? So for a 20 degree full depth involute system. So this is one of the standard system we have already discussed. So this particular Y value for a 20 degree full depth involute system is defined where Z stands for the number of teeth on the pinion, where Z stands for the number of teeth. This is a standard chart. Number of teeth on pinion means if there are, for example, 15 number of teeth, you take Y value as this. If there are our standard case, 20 number of teeth, you take Y value of this. Like this, this Y value is directly given. While solving the numerical, the Y value can be maybe directly given or many times some formula is given. By using the formula, you can also able to calculate this Y value. So just have a look to the chart. These are the various Y values given, Lewis form factor values given for number of teeth on pinion Z 15 to 300, and finally it is rack, basic rack. We have discussed about the rack. So just have a look. Okay, so this is about Z minimum number of teeth. Sorry, this is about this number of teeth on pinion and the corresponding values required for solving the problems or numericals. Okay, so the last part of this derivation or some further concluding and guideline remarks for selecting a pinion where pinion is weaker or gear is weaker. These are the guidelines which will be useful. In many of the times, we have everything is given. In such cases, we have to decide where the gear is weaker or the pinion is weaker, and based on the design, we have to proceed for further things. So, in order to avoid the breakage of gear tooth due to bending, the beam strength should be more than the effective load acting. So, it is always desired if we are not desiring the failure, then in such case, if you can say ESB, the beam strength should always greater than effective load. Effective load. We have just seen now PT, effective load we will be discussing. It is the co combination of static and dynamic load consideration into account. So it is effective load. So whatever static and dynamic load combination, that is effective load acting on the gear, if it is greater than our beam strength, definitely gear will be failed. So in this case, what is mentioned? In this case, that our SB should be always greater than or equal to, it should not also be the case. It should be always greater than P effective. If it is equal, factor of safety will be 1. And by what amount it should be greater? It is nothing but the factor of safety. It should be greater than 1.21 times. It should be greater than 1.5 times. It should be greater than 2 times. So what is this 1.52? This is nothing but the concept of factor of safety. So SB should be greater than P effective by an amount of factor of safety. In the design of gears, it is required to decide the weaker element between pinion and gear. Whenever we will be starting a design, it is always required to select whether the pinion is weaker or whether the gear is weaker. And we will be designing based on the pinion or gear. So rewriting the equation, just now we have discussed MB sigma B Y. MB sigma B Y. So here, I will take one slide and I will be explaining to you. So in his case, okay. So in this case, we are having the formula SB is equal to MB sigma B Y. So if I will write that particular formula here, SB is equal to MB sigma B into Y. This is the formula for beam strength. Now, if the gear and pinion material are different. So gear is made up of some other material and pinion is made up of some other material. So in this case, what will be same in this case? So SB is equal to module will be same for both the cases, no problem. Face width we are assuming as 10 times of module, so it will be same. So neglecting these two terms, so now SB will be totally depending upon sigma B into Y. This is neglecting means for deciding the stronger or weaker we are not considering. In the formula it is there. So SB is equal to sigma B into Y. Sigma B is the permissible bending stress for pinion material, permissible bending stress for gear material. Y, Y is the Lewis form factor for pinion material, Lewis form factor for gear material. For example, Y20 and for example, Y80. So Y20, if you refer to the chart, Y for this particular 20 case, it is 0.320 and Y for 80 case, it is 0.436. Means lesser number of teeth, Y is smaller. Higher number of teeth, Y is larger. So this is one consideration. And again, sigma B, based on the material, we will calculate the sigma B. And here in this case, this product is calculated for pinion. Again, one can this go for sigma B into Y calculation for gear. And a comparison is made, which is smaller, and deciding that that particular part is smaller. For example, sigma B into Y, what is this product? For pinion is lesser than sigma B into Y for gear. Therefore, I will design this particular gearbox based on pinion if the materials are different. It is very, very important in numericals, if all the data is given, then how to proceed. This is one point. Now I will go for the another point here. If materials are same, pinion and gear materials are same. Now see here, SB is equal to, very important, MB sigma B into Y. Module same for both the cases, face width same for both the cases. Now, materials are also same, sigma B is also same for both the cases. Now SB will only depending on Lewis form factor. SB is only depending on Lewis form factor. So here in this case, Lewis form factor is smaller. Y is less for less number of teeth. Just now we have discussed Y20. So Y for 20, 0.32. And Y for 80, 0.436. So Y value is smaller for less number of teeth. Y value is greater for higher number of teeth. So in this case, Y value is always smaller for pinion, as pinion is having always less number of teeth. Therefore, in this case, this product will be less and pinion is always weaker than gear. Gear is weaker and we have to go for designing the pinion. Very, very important concept. So why pinion is weaker? Let us have just recap between 1 minute. m b is equal to sigma b y, m same for both the cases, b same for both the cases, sigma b same material, again it is same for both the cases, the product is defined on y only. And y value is the Lewis form factor. It depends upon the number of teeth acting in the gear, and number of teeth are always lesser for pinion. Therefore, this y value is always lesser for pinion. And if y value is less, ultimately the sigma b will also less for pinion. Therefore, in one line, I will conclude, if materials are same, pinion is always weaker. If materials are different, then this product will decide which part is weaker. If materials are same, pinion is always weaker. If materials are different, this product will decide which part is weaker. Thank you, friends. Now,